Did you know that Lowell's first trolley was in operation in 1889?
I did. They were called electric streetcars at the time. In 1984, the Lowell National Park reestablished the cars as part of the city's historical restoration.
Every day, hundreds of people travel free on the trolley, stopping at 14 of the city's new and not-so-new landmarks.
Join us for an exciting ride, and we'll see where the trolley stops next.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to Little Asher Park, home of the Lowell Spinners.
Hi, I'm Connor Baldwin, and I'm here with Tim Bauman, the Vice President and General Manager of the Lowell Spinners. Welcome, Tim. Thank you for coming with us.
It's great. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. I want to start by talking about this legendary first base that you guys have here. I understand it was recently acquired by the Spinners. If you could maybe tell us a little bit about the history.
Yeah, well, I think obviously in the heart of Red Sox Nation, everybody knows about the slap. When A-Rod in 2004 was running down the baseline, Bronson Arroyo tried to tag him out, and A-Rod slapped the ball out of his hand, and then he reached first base safely. Umpires converged. They decided he had slapped intentional to call him out. But we have the base. It's at first base. We bought it off a collector's memorabilia site through a sponsorship. Electrical Wholesalers is our sponsorship. So we use it in our games every night. It's got the official American League 2004 logo on the base, an American League logo on the base. And then in the off season, it will go through all the Electrical Wholesalers distribution sites. So it'll be on display as well. So, you know, we like to be a little bit different here in Lowell, and I think that's it's fun for the fans.
Well, that's great. I'm sure that'll be a great attraction for this season. I'd like to also talk a little bit about how the Spinners attribute to Lowell's baseball culture with the youth leagues and then further to the Red Sox, if you could talk about the Spinners' role and all that.
A couple of different things. We're involved pretty heavily in the Little Leagues here in the greater Lowell area. We've got several teams in the Lowell area that are named after us. They're actually the Spinners. You know, most Little League teams are named after big league clubs, the A's, the Braves, the Angels, things like that. We started a program a couple of years ago called Yankees Elimination Promotion,
yeah,
where if you were a Yankees team, we'd offer to pay for your new uniforms in favor of the Spinners. So I think all told we have 70 youth baseball teams throughout the country that are Spinners, but we have the majority of them right here in the greater Lowell area. And then what we do is we invite those youngsters to come out on the field before our game. Like tonight, for instance, we'll have a group out there that will play a little mock baseball game on the field. So that's the first step. The second step is a couple of years ago we started what's called the Lowell Spinners World Series, and we have four local high school baseball teams that come out and play a double elimination tournament, and then we crown a champion, and the team that loses both games is out. We invite a new team in the next year, and then the teams that continue to win, we invite them back every year. So it's really an opportunity for us to get the youngsters out on this field to see. You know, Jonathan Papelbon played here, Kevin Euculus played here, so it's an opportunity for them to toe the same mound that Papelbon did and, you know, run the bases like Kevin Euculus did. So it's important to us.
All right, excellent. Before we go, I was hoping you could maybe, off the top of your head, go over some of the can't-miss matchups or events going on here at Little Asher Park this season.
Well, you know, our big promotions are bobblehead dolls. In fact, we got a bobblehead night coming up here shortly. It's James Whistler. You know, he's a local artist from years ago, back in the 20th century, that drew the famous picture of his mother. She'll be here. An actress portraying her will be here at the ballpark. You know, we're going to do a Mike Lowell bobblehead doll this year. Those are big nights for us. Everybody seems to like the bobblehead dolls. I think one of the most fun promotions we're going to have this year, Steven Guskowski, who's the field goal kicker for the New England Patriots, will be here shortly, and he's going to be kicking autographed footballs into the stands. So I think that'll be fun, and I think it'll be a night where a lot of football fans can come out and enjoy themselves.
All right, excellent. Tim, thank you very much for joining us. Good luck to you this season. Thank you. All right, I'm here with Jim now, and he's going to tell us a little bit about last night's spinner's victory.
It was an awesome game. Almost had an awesome catch in left field, but he must have misplayed it, and then he had a shot at another one. Didn't get it, but a lot of potential out there. They're hustling, and it looks like they know what they're doing, and they're patient at the plate.
You think this might be a good season for the spinners?
I hope so. You know, we were close, you know, a couple of years ago there. This year we had a couple of Gulf Coast League guys that won the championship last year. I told them to bring it to us this year. So we'll see what happens.
All right, thank you very much. Have a great night. Enjoy the game.
We're here with number 28, Dan Milano, who was a catcher for the Lowell Spinners. Previously, he played at Northeastern University. Now he's playing here. What's it like living in the same area your whole life and then playing here?
I couldn't ask for a better place to play. I'm only 50 minutes away from home, but 40 minutes away from the city. It's great having my family and friends being able to come watch me. I'm really looking forward to the opportunity to get on the field and show what I could do, perform out there, and I'm just real thankful for the opportunity.
Sounds great. Now at Northeastern, you had a 19-game hitting streak, which is the record there. What was going through your mind that whole time? How did you get in such a zone where you were just cranking everything?
The trick is, like they say, is not to think about it. Just forget about it, put it out of your head, and go out there and play. And that's what I did. I think it was like the 17th game. I was 0 for my first three. It started creeping into my head a little bit, and I just sat back on a curveball and drove in the left field for a base hit to keep it alive. So.
Well, congratulations on that, and thank you for having this interview with us, and good luck tonight. We have number 18, Eric Beatty. He's a right-handed pitcher for the Spinners. He pitches mid-relief, and he's going to tell us a little bit about what it's like to pitch in minor league baseball.
It's fun. It's baseball.
And what's it like when you come out here and everybody's screaming and you got to get that out, bases loaded? What's going through your head at that point?
It's a great atmosphere and makes it all the more fun.
And you're from the South, from Florida, mm-hmm. And you say the atmosphere down there is something you're more used to, but you enjoy the Cape Cod leagues. You enjoy. Have you been around Lowell at all yet?
This is my first time in Lowell. Like you said, I was in the Cape Cod for 3 years ago for a couple months. So reminds me a little bit of that. But like you said, I'm from the South, so I'm a little more used to it. But it's different up here. I like it though. I like it.
Well, that's good to hear. Good luck tonight. We hope you do good and hope you get those outs.
Thanks a lot, man.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
Hi, the trolley has stopped at the Sampas Pavilion along the Merrimack River. Today we're going to experience the African culture through dining, art, and music. Gary Cadet. Gary's an African